Show. Tonight we celebrate Don's 50th birthday and the end of a very special era in television. After 9 years, let me say for the last time, and now, here's Don!
That said, thank you very much. I appreciate that, but that's enough. You keep that up, they might change their mind. Obviously, they saved all the crazy people for the last show, right? Are you the crazy people? It's good that it's okay for you people. You've got a job to go to in the morning. It's not so easy for a 50-year-old unemployed Jew. You're ready to have a great time at home. We're going to have a good time tonight. This is a big celebration. I hope you in here get in the spirit of everything and have a terrific time. Anyway, to start things off, hi.
Hi!
Ah, you're talking. Welcome to the last Don Lane Show for 1983. 1984, 85, 86, 87, 88. They don't muck around down here, you know. I walked through the foyer tonight, my photo's not there anymore. Just a big sign saying next. You know, it's really weird. And did they forget quickly? I was driving to the studios today and I stopped for a light and the lady in the car next to me stuck her head out the window and said, aren't you the bloke who used to work with Bert Newton? You know? And you know who's the most upset? You know, it always comes to surprise me. Sir Eric Pierce. I mean, he's so upset that my program is finishing. Honestly, it's good. He always has my show on at home. You see, he uses it as a night light in case he has to go to the bathroom. Of course, this actually is not the last Don Lane show. There's still a big spectacular on December the 7th when I auction my house with $1 million worth of jewelry buried in a cellar. By the way, if you'd like to attend the auction, just write to the ticket secretary, Don Lane Auction, Richmond 3121, and don't forget to enclose a self-addressed stamped envelope with a check for $700,000, and we'll be very happy to let you all in there. Tonight is a celebration. It's the last Don Lane show and my 50th birthday, which actually comes on Sunday, but we're celebrating tonight, and we intend to keep it a happy occasion, okay? No downers tonight. We're going to have a great time, and to open the show, we've got a song for you that features myself, the girls in the ballet looking absolutely lovely and spectacular, and Graham Lyle and the best band in television. So let's have a little music and we're off. All right, here we go.
Stay where you are, listen to me, before you make your mind up what the wind-up ought to be. Though it used to be chic for the songs to be bleak, the path to be sad has been had. And though I like a blues song, here and there, those moody albums made to cry by sent me nowhere. Misery may be some people's cup of tea, but
brother.
Not me. It makes me feel so good when I see a happy ending. Give me a happy ending every time. It makes me feel so bad when the curtain is descending and lovers aren't blending. That's a crime. Now in a western, the time I really love it is when the doctor yells hot water and plenty of it. Now if that's corny, don't ever let them stop porn. I want to relax and eat my popcorn. So bring the girls down front when you make that final fade out and make that final fade out look sublime. Let them rip it, let them rock it, leave their hankies in their pocket. Give me a happy ending every time. And how about a hand for the girls? The hero to be the one who done it. Don't want the heroine left all alone to gun it. And when the villain's bullets rip the hero's hat away, look out!
They went that away.
So bring the girls down front when you make that final fade out and make that final fade out look sublime. Let them rip it, let them rock it, leave their hankies in their pockets. I love a happy ending every time. Happy ending every time.
We went for the maitre d' look. I might be looking for a job.
It looks nice, Don. During the show this evening, do you mind if I get any stuff on it? At all? I know.
No, don't.
I don't, brand new.
Don,
he's
this...
ruined more clothes of mine than you can count.
This is going to be a very special night, as we well know.
Can I tell people that the rest of this is out of my hands until
Certainly.
We close the show?
The rest of this is out of Don's hands. You tell them. Go on.
The rest of this is out of my hands.
He knows nothing about what's going to happen between now and, I would suggest, about 12 midnight tonight.
You people are in for a very long night. You two at home.
You people over there are in for a very long night, and also those people at home, too.
By the way, if they happen to be watching Thornbirds,
yes,
the score is 6 dead. Catholics 2, Australians 0. It's wonderful.
Don, with the Thornbirds on against us down here in Melbourne, do you think we'd have anyone watching us?
Probably Colleen McCulloch, I think.
Thank you. That's the first food you're giving.
Nice. Don, okay, let me tell you, we do have lots of surprises for you tonight.
Okay.
The first surprise is we have no present for you.
Right. That's no surprise.
The second surprise is a lot of the artists couldn't make it. So what I'm doing, I'm going to do about 40 minutes of my club act for you. I'll just go to center stage. You don't mind that, do you? I'm not even going to have 20 minutes.
I haven't had a laugh in 2 weeks.
And you won't get it in the next 35 minutes either. Don, tonight is a very special show, as you say, not only for you, but also for the people here in the audience and the people at home. Don doesn't know what's happening. So what's new?
By the way, it's also, without sounding corny, it's also a special night for everybody in the studio. Because we are all proud of pulling together, and this is a big team in here that's done a great job, and this show is everybody's tonight. Okay,
exactly. Well, I think the important thing to set out right from the start is that it is not a wake. It's a celebration of
I'm going.
It's all right. You'll be okay.
It's not a wake. It's a celebration of 9 years of wonderful television. Don, do you realize what we've done in 9 years? We have capsulized for you right now just some of the many highlights of the GTV9 career of Don and his show.
There we go.
St. George's Step Up Savings Plan, and you automatically step up your interest rate without tying up your money. $2,000 starts it, and even if you withdraw right down to the last dollar, you're ahead with Building Society interest, but automatically step up to higher and higher interest as you add to it. Get the best of both worlds automatically. Higher daily interest and instant withdrawals. Ask for the Step Up Savings Guide.
What a great idea, St. George!
In fly sprays? You don't know how sensitive people can be. One patient's eyes watered so much we got a flathead under his bed. And poor Mr. White here sneezed so hard we had to reset his plaster 6 times. So now I use this new Mortein Low Irritant. It's faster than ever, but gentle as Dr. Lovejoy's bedside manner.
Yes!
Mortein's one of the few things here that don't get up your nose.
Mortein, now faster than ever. Kind to sensitive noses. This is the new Vulcan Dishlex Mark 8. It has 2 separate zones. Up top, a fine, gentle spray carefully cleans your delicate dishes and glassware, while down below, ferocious jets of water scour the baked-on murk from your greasy pots and pans. It's called Hydropulse Action, and it means Dishlex is the only dishwasher that combines heaven and hell in one cycle. Dishlex Mark 8 from Vulcan.
Fruit juice, cake, bread, sandwich fillings, fruit. Look, is that Rita?
You know what we forgot?
You forgot the Eat a Five Star. Great race, Rita.
You should run for Australia.
I was running for Eat a Five Star, love. Whoops. How's it taste?
Rita!
You're on an all-Australian winner when you get the taste of Eat a Five Star.
Can you help us spot the people in trouble? Right now, it's as hard for us to see them as it is you. And we're the rescue helicopter. But there is a machine that can help us find people easily. In the ocean, or in the forest at night, or under the thick smoke of a bushfire. It's called FLIR, an infrared scanner. It's available to us now if we can raise the money. Please send a donation. Every little bit helps. Think about it. One day the person we find could be someone you know.
Well, here we are in the celebrity room, the Ark, here at Channel 9, and we're having our own private party, Don and Bert. So many of the people who've helped us on the show over the last 9 years are here. Gary Van Egmond, Andrew Gill, Dennis Smith, the promoter. Philip Brady is even in the room, ladies and gentlemen. We've got Carol Smith. Remember Carol, the former wheel girl from the old IMT days? Mike Barnett is here. Even Reno the Butcher.
Look at that. Isn't that incredible? He's found his way in here, and I don't mean to be cutting. Down the back there, we've got Graham McDonough, the guy who's responsible for the wheel, all the prizes, Nick Collum. He's only be a name to most people. He's only a name to us. And so many other celebrities down here, including the girl from the wardrobe department. We'll be back a little bit later on for some more local colour. Back to you, Don.
Thank you very much, Peter. All those people are in the ark. Unbelievable. They're not too thrilled in here that all those people are in there in New York. There's going to be nothing left for anybody to eat by the time we get out of here. I can tell that coming. Here's a lady that the first time I ever saw her was on Prisoner, and I had no idea what she was going to be like. They said this lady's going to come onto the show. I said, what's she going to do? Wear a pair of overalls and give me a hernia or something? I had no idea. But anyway, she's turned into one of the brightest and cleverest ladies I have ever had the pleasure of meeting. Would you please say hello to Colette Mann here? This is not your formal gear, but you've worn flat shoes.
I decided I'd go opposite to everyone else.
Yes.
Everyone else has gone formal. I thought I'd go really cash, you know?
Well, I think it looks great. You don't want to wear heels because you don't want that long, slim, beautiful look.
No, nothing like that. I want to look little and dumpy on your last night.
Right, okay. I love you just the way you are.
Oh, thank you. Now, look, I have to tell you, because would you believe
I have very... What are those two lumps on the side of your head there?
I don't know. They're covering up something ugly underneath. Now,
you look like a geriatric Mickey Mouse Club member.
Oh, thank you very much.
I love you.
Thank you very much. Now, look, would you believe that on our very last night together, they've only given me a small amount of time? You wouldn't believe it, would you?
You're kidding.
I'm going to have to talk very fast.
No, you don't. Take all the time you want. What's he going to do, fire you?
Exactly.
You got it.
He can't make me fired. I'm quitting.
No, forget it.
That would have worked. Now, listen, what I want to talk to you about is the fact that I came out here, I spent 2 days looking for a very special birthday present and a goodbye present for you at the same time. And I started off, the best thing is I did it all on film, so I thought you'd have a look at it first, you see. And I started off at the shops first. Could we see the shops first?
Sure.
Because I thought I'll start at the shops. Nice. Yes, I started. See, I had a determined look on my face and I was off and away, you see.
Right.
And I went in. I looked for shoes because you were getting the boot, you know. It was very hard in the shops. Now, I didn't think that'd suit you. so then I continued on. I started to get a bit panicky at this point, you know, because I wandered all through these places. I went to computer places. I went to Tony Barlow's, but he dresses Tony Barber. He wasn't interested. And I went to Sale and Petra Hair Care, but your hair's lovely. And I was really panic struck and found nothing at Tandy Electronics. But the run up the stairs did me a world of good, let me tell you. World in here. Look at this gentleman. He loves it. Couldn't bear it. Couldn't find anything. And then just when things were getting really bad, I found this stuffed kangaroo. And it gave me a really good idea. I thought, something to remind you of Australia, you see.
Right.
So out I went to the zoo. But I had trouble wrapping it up. Then I thought I'd try a tram. But I had trouble wrapping that one up too. Because, do you know what? I wouldn't have had so much trouble wrapping it up. It was just that it wouldn't stand still.
Right, okay.
And it also, as well as that, if anybody remembers Tuesday, this was just before the rain. And, of course, it rained and all my paper got wet. Look, and then I thought I remembered you liked the Melbourne football team.
Right.
So I was lurking behind a tree. Look. And I nearly caught them, too. In actual fact, I decided that everything that I was going for was running away from me. I'd go for something static. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I must admit, though, I almost caught the Melbourne football team. No wonder they didn't win too many games last year. Now, I decided I was going very well with this. I would have needed just a little bit more paper, but I felt that it was static, and it was probably... Perhaps a little big for what I wanted.
There'll be a lot of overweight on the plane.
Yeah, I decided I'd go for something a little more accessible. Now, this is the beautiful Yarra. And I was very busy getting you something from the Yarra.
Right.
And it was very hard because it was very cold by this stage. But I finally got it, and I got some Yarra water in a Vegemite jar for you.
Right.
Now, I brought it in here, and it's wrapped, so that's... You're not very thrilled, are you?
Well, I suppose it's all right. Yarra water?
Yeah, well, you don't have to open it. Well, Well, actually, no. That is inside there. Do you want to open it? It is Vegemite water in a Yarra jar. No. It's I'm so excited.
Yarra water in a Vegemite jar.
That's right.
Do I open it now?
No, you can take it back to America. You believe
well,
me,
I better not declare it. Go through customs. I'll think it's a specimen or something.
Well, actually, I was surprised at how clean it was. It's got a bit of, you know, gunk in it.
Right.
You know, like a bit of flotsam and jetsam. But, you know, remember them are a good act.
Are you kidding? I live with one of them.
But, no, truly, all jokes aside, that's what people say.
Right.
This is what I really got for you as a birthday present and a going away present. And it's friends who, you can see it now. I'd like... Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Don. Happy birthday to you. Good luck in America, and remember,
this towel here, so...
I'm supposed to say something else now.
Those kids... If you could have seen the letters that those kids sent me, they wrote me letters, it's wonderful. Those kids have never heard a word I've ever uttered or a note I've ever sung, and they just love me. They're terrific.
Wonderful. Yeah. I'm supposed to make us all happy now. I'm doing a real good job at it, aren't I?
You're not supposed to get emotional. You see, if anybody else is going to get emotional, I go very easily.
I know you
I can't stand this anymore. Look at this. They're doing this over here, too. Can you imagine what's going to happen when Thornbirds is over? They would have been crying their guts out. For 3 hours, they'll cry their guts out. They'll tune into us to the ending, and they'll be going, what are you doing? Television, I don't want to watch it anymore.
Now, listen, I've got to make us all laugh here now.
Oh, yeah.
Now, have I got something that you can laugh at? Have I got something really special for you?
What's that?
This is my friend, Kevin Arnett, doing something he's never done before. It's really fabulous. I have now named him the Great Arnett Biscuit.
Is that...
I would like you to see him. I said to him after I saw this at rehearsal, don't give up your day job. However, we'll still be on the weather. Here he is, Kevin Arnett.
All right, yeah, good morning, sir.
Thank you very much, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, it's my great pleasure on this last Don Lane show to show you one of the most amazing things ever seen on television in this country. Forget the Filipino healers I brought you some years ago. Forget Doris Stokes and the Bermuda Triangle. This will blow your aura, I guarantee. It will not only amaze you, it will shock you. It's totally fantastic. But to do this trick tonight, I need the most fantastic assistant I can find in this whole country. The most beautiful, curvaceous, wonderful girl I know. Ladies and gentlemen, my assistant Colette Mann.
That's
what you said last night. I want to show you that there's nothing concealed on my person.
Oh, what a thrill.
That's what everybody
said.
Nothing up my sleeve. Nothing up that sleeve, ladies and gentlemen.
His hands never leave his arms.
You just see the rest of my body. Here is the rest of my body, ladies and gentlemen. Nothing concealed whatsoever.
Gorgeous.
I'll lift my flap at the back.
Oh, how ugly.
That's enough, Graham. I'm going tonight, Colette, to do the most amazing piece of magic with you. I'm going to saw you literally in half.
Oh, good.
There will now be two of you.
Oh, whatever you've got. So, and there's enough for two.
Well, let's find out. I would like you, first of all, to lay on my chaise lounge.
Yeah, right.
Oh, you mean you really...
You stay out of this.
No, hang on. You mean you're really going to do this?
I'm going to saw you in
half. I thought you were joking at rehearsal. You really mean we're going to do this now?
I've been practicing once or twice.
Oh, terrific.
This is like my weather forecasts.
Oh, we know how good that is.
Would you like to lie down? Your head facing this way.
Oh, most certainly.
Now, just hold it steady.
I'd hate to just go down on, you know, national television that I broke.
Leave me alone!
Are you ready?
Yes.
Now, Don, I have to have your assistance now. I want you as a witness for this.
Right.
Now, Don, you and I have known each other for many years.
Unfortunately, yes, we have.
No. We've had a lot of fun.
Good.
And now I know you so well, it's the last show. I've got something warm in my pocket I'd like you to hold for me.
Okay.
Would you please put your hand around that? I want to show you that this... this tonight is the real...
Lay thing. Down on the table when you belong.
Get down on the table! Now hold that story. This is the real thing.
This may interest you to know that I've had this done once before many years ago.
You're all the better for it.
Yes.
Now, wait a minute.
What's this?
This is to hold you in so that you don't scream or wriggle around too much.
Oh,
wait a minute, I've got to find the slot. John, do you know where the slot is?
I have no idea.
Breathe in, breathe in.
Oh, my God.
Gosh, I've never done these gloves before.
Oh.
That's it. Are you right? Steady?
Yeah.
Don't worry, Mona. She's going to be okay, kid. It's just a little magic.
I can't get the damn thing down.
What do you want? Is the story of your life?
You should be so lucky.
Oh, my cucumber. Have you got
here
it right? Got it.
Yeah, now, here we go.
Right.
This is the most amazing thing ever seen on TV.
What are you going to do? Saw her in half?
I'm going to saw Colette in half like you've never seen before. Which half do you want?
I don't know. Is that a real
Let's
saw
begin.
And all that?
Yes, this is the real thing. Now, you're going to say your prayers now?
I think I'm sick.
Here we go. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, Colette Mann is now 2 feet.
Your line, but quite fantastic, I think.
This is my line for next year.
Is that it?
Now, I've got to get Colette out of this.
Yeah, get me out of this,
wait a
Kevin.
Oh, Colette,
oh, don't give up talking about the weather, will you, Kevin?
Look, forget. Can we have a commercial break now? Is that what's come up? Huh? We're having a commercial. Pick up the other end, will you please?
Okay.
Oh. We'll be back after this break.
We'll be back.
What makes Blue Omo Australia's number one washing product?
In cold water, there's nothing better. I have tried other products in cold water, but they just don't brighten like Omo. And there's nothing more depressing than a grey wash. At vintage time, we all get really dirty. But Omo gets even our dirtiest things clean and bright first time round. Omo saves you time and money.
We've got the big, clean brightness right across our big country.
Deep spring and lemon. Deep spring and orange.
Gotta be the most refreshing sight.
Deep spring and grapefruit.
You've ever seen.
Orange and mango. From Deep Spring, four sparkling mineral juices. They're twice as refreshing because they combine real fruit juice with natural mineral water.
Gotta be the most refreshing sight you've ever seen.
Okay. Now that the show is going to be over, one of the guys has signed on as station handyman. Now, he knows it all, like how to paint over fibro bricks and timber and galvanized iron without using a primer or an undercoat. Would you like to meet him? Here he is. This is our handyman. Everybody's handyman. Yes, sir.
Good on you. Supposed to wear the thing and it wouldn't print.
Is that right?
Yes.
Oh, thank you very much.
You're but not on the suit. Nothing on the suit. You might notice for it. Hang on, son.
I'm going well, mate. Hi. Nice to see you.
Glad to see you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, good. I'm glad.
I am a handyman Bert, doing another one of my fabulous characters. And I am to the rescue with Wattle Solar Guard.
Okay, what are you doing, actually?
Well, Chester the Wattle Horse here is, has always said that Solar Guard is mighty good exterior paint.
In other words, it's a good paint horse.
Yes, indeed.
Quit horsing around.
Horsing around, you see, that's the sort of stuff that gave you
a little written in humor we have.
Wattle Solar Guard, on a serious note, as you can see.
It covers what?
It covers, for a start, fibro. Fibro, careful of the suit here, mate.
Wait a minute.
Careful of the suit.
This is fibro.
It covers fibro like so. Look at that.
All right, that's terrific.
It covers bricks.
Bricks, you got it.
It covers, timber. Right. Tin.
No, galvanized iron.
Galvanized iron, and also it covers
timber.
Timber and zinc.
That's a lovely shade of green. Did you pick that up?
I certainly did. It's got a special name, which unfortunately I can't tell you on telly. It's an acrylic, by the way, and it's got oil added. And as you know, Sol, oil's ain't oil. Hey, you know something, too?
What is that?
It's made especially for harsh Australian climates, which, of course, won't affect you now, will it?
No, no, it won't. Right.
And brushes wash out in water.
Look at that.
As you can...
It's a bloody miracle.
Isn't that amazing? Look, you can still see the green paint everywhere.
No, it wasn't. And Waddle Solar God comes in gloss... Hands off the cans.
I beg your pardon?
Comes in gloss.
Yep.
Or low sheen.
Low sheen.
In a popular range of colors. Green. No. Does he know any good horse jokes?
There is green, there is brown, and there's one you get when you mix them together.
Does he know any good horse jokes? Does he know any good horse jokes?
He certainly does.
Does he? What did he say?
Everybody's getting into the act.
What did he say?
He said, trust Waddle Paints.
He did not.
Sure can.
While Australia was busy growing up, a great Australian tradition was being born, growing stronger and brighter on our southern horizon. For nearly two centuries, this great tradition has cared for children, families, and the elderly. One family symbolizes this great benevolent society, and today this symbol stands for care and compassion. The Benevolent Society of New South Wales. Help us keep this great Australian tradition in the pink.
I have to say honestly, and we've talked about it many times, I have been a fan of Johnny Farnham since the days when I had my show in Sydney and he had a hit record called Sadie the Cleaning Lady. And boy, I'll tell you, he has come a long, long way since then. He's been associated with us from the very beginning. And I loved him as a solo performer, and I always thought that Johnny Farnham was one of the greatest talents ever produced in this country. So did the Little River Band, because they decided that he was going to become their lead singer. By the way, tonight he's going to be accompanied by a new member of the Little River Band, David Hirschfelder, who's going to be backing him on piano. Now, the truth of the matter is, Johnny just returned, literally, 3 days ago. And he came home early just to be with us, of which I'm really proud. He's been on a whirlwind, very successful tour of the USA with LRB, culminating in three sellout nights at the huge and glamorous Universal Amphitheater. A whole 7,000-something people, they were sold out every single night that they were there, Universal Studios in Hollywood. Like I said, only the best voice, I think, ever produced in this country. Ladies and gentlemen, Johnny Farnham.
I've got to tell you, as long as I've been doing this show, it frightens the life out of me every time.
Why is that?
I don't know. Live television always, I'm shaking like a leaf. I don't believe it.
You're all right. You were a little edgy this afternoon, too. You said when you were rehearsing.
Yeah. Well, I haven't worked on my own for 3 years.
Oh, that's true. Is that 3 years ago?
Yeah. And I stand up there and think, it's all my fault. If I blow this, I can't turn around and say, ha, you blew it.
Yeah. How was the tour? Tell me about the tour.
It was fantastic.
Yeah?
It was absolutely fantastic.
Was that right? The amphitheater holds 7,500 or something?
Yeah, 7,500 people. We did actually 4 nights there.
Great.
It was really good. It caps off the tour beautifully.
Yeah.
And it really came off. We were very, very happy indeed.
Well, John, I'll tell you what, there aren't many that sing as good as you, kid, and I just, you know me, I've been a fan since the year one. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Absolutely wonderful.
All the best in the world, mate. Thanks for having me back.
Okay, mate. No worries. Johnny Fine. Put the one out. Maybe we'll do this. Okay. Thank you. Great. Boy, can he sing. As I say, it's cut your throat time, right? You hear him sing, you say, what am I bothering for? I'll go to the world. Here's a fella. I have two writers, actually. One is called Mike McCall Jones, who no one has ever seen, nor will they ever on camera. He looks like a Cheshire cat, and he hides out a lot. He never comes on. The other writer I have is a fella called Tim Evans. You probably know him from Bert's New Faces. He's a judge, and you can't keep him off camera. That's a little thing to go with. But anyway, he is also a very good friend. A fellow American, originally from Texas, but he's been living here as long as me, married to an Australian girl. How about it? Tim Evans. Yeah, come on. Now, wait a minute. They didn't tell me what you're going to do, but you're not going to read me a lot of the leftover gags now.
Well, no, we're not going to do that tonight. What I have here, actually, is the last will and testament of the Don Lane Show.
The last will and testament?
Well, I mean, it is the last show, so I thought it only fitting that we did read the will, you know.
You've never showed me those glasses. Do you wear those?
Well, I found out I needed them last week when I picked up a snake and tried to kill a stick with it. I do want to point out that this particular document, it is a legitimate will, folks.
Right.
This document has been drawn up by your very own solicitor, Swindle, Diddle, and Shove It, so it's
right,
all
yes, there. I know.
It says that I, Martin Donald Isaacson...
Martin, is that Morton or Martin?
Martin Donald Isaacson.
That sounds a bit funny there, right there.
Also known as Don Lane, also known as the Lanky Yankee, and also known as that tall, skinny, septic poofed on the telly.
Right.
Being of almost sane mind and semi-sound body, and out of work with only one offer from Channel O 28, which is the same as being dead, do hereby declare this to be my last will and testament for the Don Lane Show.
Right.
To my executive producer, Peter Feynman, I leave my entire collection of nose jokes.
Right.
Especially the one about when Peter took a cruise on the QE2, stuck his head out the porto to see where they were going, and turned the boat around.
You remember? Very good, yes. We all remember that one. Yes, right, yes.
Now, to the boys in videotape, my eternal gratitude for giving me a videotape of each show, and in particular for the copy of the X-rated Australian movie, Debbie Does Dimboola. You remember that?
Yeah. How could you forget that?
To Kevin Arnett, I leave my most treasured possession, a live recording of Doris Stokes talking to Moses. You can also play the spirit side. To our show photographer, Barry Bell, I leave my lounge suite in the hope that he'll have better luck taking shots on it than I did.
Hang on.
Well,
Barry does all right, by the way.
To my faithful pianist, Bootsy, better known as Mr. Excitement. I leave my favorite bedside book entitled 360 Ways to Make Love, including the misprint on page 39, which caused me to spend 6 weeks in traction. To Izzy Dye, whom I promised to remember in my will, hello, Izzy.
I love it.
To James Randi, I leave nothing. As far as I'm concerned, you can still put... I can't read that one. To the buyer of my house, which is being auctioned on December 7th, all the places, a map showing all the places I've dug trying to find the $1 million worth of buried jewelry.
Yes,
we might as well see if we can get a few more at the auction.
The jewels are there at the house, folks. Yes,
to the Melbourne Football Club, I leave my car, including the statuette of Ron Barassi on the dashboard. to Kamal, that wonderful, wonderful man. I leave my favorite record album entitled Tiny Tim and the Sex Pistols Sing the Best of Slim Dusty. That's a record. To my dog Shadow, I leave Carrie Packer's leg. Wanna?
Oh, by the way, you still working here?
I don't know.
Wanted to make a reservation on the plane.
Want to hear the last one? I'll come back to the flat and do jokes for you to talk on the phone. To my tennis coach, I leave all my rackets, including the sweep on the wheel, the South Sydney Chook raffle, and my secret formula for the herpes vanishing cream.
Right, that's true.
To all the TV critics everywhere who have reviewed my show over the past 8.5 years, to show there's no hard feelings, I've sent each of you the name of a local taxidermist, and I sincerely hope that you'll go. To my sidekick, Bert Newton, I leave the unexpired term of my sickness and accident insurance policy in case he should unexpectedly fall down and break his hair. Well, and finally, to the powers that be here at Channel 9, my undying gratitude for my 50th birthday present, all those shares in the uranium mine. They didn't give me the whole mine, but they did give me the shaft. You just sign it here, if you will.
Yes, I think. You got a pen? You haven't got a pen.
I gave you one.
I'll sign it here when I get a minute, okay? Yes. Tim, you're terrific, mate.
My
and
place.
For the years of service, I can't thank you enough.
For the best male performer for performances in 1976. The final contenders are Don Lane, Bert Newton, and Mike Walsh.
And the winner is Don Lane.
I don't take something like this for granted. I don't think it's anything to really... Well, it's fun and it's nice, but it's nothing to joke about and make fun of. And I know you'll know that I mean this when I do it. Here, pal. 6 months in your house and 6 months in mine. How's that, all right?
Saturday night at the movies.
Our only hope for victory is one massive strike at Midway.
A superb motion picture. Battle of Midway.
A naval battle where the opponents never see each other.
An epic of unforgettable scope and power.
How many carriers? What course? What speed?
Of war's gigantic gambles.
I am convinced Yamamoto's target is Midway.
If you're wrong, Admiral, the entire west coast and Hawaiian Island would be wide open for invasion.
If it's Midway, I'll bushwhack him.
And the personal drama behind the biggest air and sea battle of the Pacific.
I've fallen in love with a Japanese girl.
6 months after Pearl Harbor, boy, you have one lousy sense of timing.
The boy's got to learn, man. You do not win a war by kissing the enemy. No.
Charlton Heston, Henry Fonda, Robert Wagner, James Coburn, Cliff Robertson, Robert Mitchum, and Glenn Ford.
If we launch now, we just might catch Nagumo like a sitting duck.
Battle of Midway, Saturday, 8 o'clock, Channel 9.
Someone's watching, someone's peeping, everyone's eyes on mum. Sunday's coming, it's worth waiting, waiting for fun.
Now, Sunday is more fun than ever. New Choc Mint Sunday with yummy, crunchy choc pieces in vanilla and mint sunday. Wow! And how about new fruit salad sunday? Vanilla and strawberry sunday with delicious fruit pieces. So now there's four great sunday flavors.
And sweets make sunday, so you know it's the one with all the fun.
Merry Christmas from everyone here at Morris Discount Fabrics. And to make your Christmas really special, you'll get free curtain making and ready in time for Christmas. Just choose from Mars' entire decorator range, and Mars' little elves will make your curtains up absolutely free and in time for Christmas. But you'll have to hurry. The elves need your measurements now, so I can see the job on Christmas Eve. Have a Merry Christmas at Mars' Discount Fabrics. Ho, ho, ho!
Remember the great race in 82 when Ford pulled ahead of the rest by just 137 sales? Well, this year, we're 21,000 ahead. And Ford dealers are determined to help you join the winning team. So right now, they're doing great deals on Falcon, Telstar, Meteor, and Spectra. So get into the winner's circle. See your Ford dealer now, because with the great deals they're offering, you'll be the winner.
The cats of Australia Chris. Have made their choice.
And you see, Nathan.
Snappy Tom. Snappy Tom. It's Snappy Tom time. They raise up their voice. Snappy Tom.
Snappy Tom. A whole range of delicious fish varieties.
The cats of Australia have made their choice. Snappy Tom.
The cat's choice.
Snappy Tom.
Walk this way. Done. Let me tell you, if you blinked your eyes, I hope you blinked your eyes, you have missed our surprise.
I didn't see anything.
You know, I know you didn't see anything at all, but the people at home might realize. We have something very special for you on your birthday. I know it's not your birthday today. It's your birthday when on Sunday.
Sunday,
isn't it?
Sunday.
But we'd like to sing happy birthday for you, and we do have just a little thing which we thought you might like to take home with you. Now, you've got to consider, of course, when you're flying home, as you are tomorrow, it's got to be something which is able to fit in your luggage and something that's going to be convenient for you.
And something that customs won't arrest me for. Right?
Exactly. Been there, done that.
Yes, true, of course.
Don.
We're old friends.
Boys, ladies and gentlemen, for Don. We get the goal. And look at the chef over there. Monsieur Morisson, who was over there.
I can't believe it. Max is the chef, and the cake hasn't collapsed or fallen off.
Do you realize, Don, this, by the way, is, you mightn't know it, is a real cake. I mean, for example, would you like to try some? Look at that.
No. Oh, no. You're going to give me whipped cream like the
Your
last
soup?
Is that? Which, try. Is that shaving cream?
No, it's, I promise you it's not.
I'll take
some. No, from my finger. Real cream?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's a real cake. Do you like it?
Yeah.
That's not the end of the surprise.
Can watch your fingers. You get your suit.
I don't care.
Oh.
Surprise number two.
But thanks, ladies. Okay, thank you. What a surprise. First of all, how'd they get you inside that cake?
I was baked.
Were you baked?
Yes.
You came out just for this show?
Just for you.
I don't believe
just
you.
Just say goodbye from Australia and hello to America.
Oh, yeah? Will you be there when I get there?
I certainly will. I'm going home to receive you.
Are you? Yes. We're going to have a lot of good things happening
there,
aren't we?
Oh, yes. We're neighbors now.
Oh, yes. That's right.
This was a long trip, you know.
Yes? Are you afraid of flying?
No.
No? Doesn't bother you?
I'm afraid of not flying.
All right.
But I was so happy to leave. I'd go any place to get away from Fang.
Yeah, still bugging you, isn't he?
He was in such a rotten mood because he was doing push-ups in the nude and he didn't notice the mouse trap.
Kivy, he's very snappy now, isn't he?
Oh, and a new dress just for you.
Now, the last time you came, we had the fella that used to be in wardrobe here.
Doug Denham.
Now,
Allison Baker. This is
Allison Baker. Allison Baker.
Look at this. She baked it.
She made that just for you.
Oh, it's like a court jester, you see.
Yes.
This is all solid gold.
Is it?
See,
what about the hair?
Seaweed.
Yeah, that's right.
You see, I dress to please myself. I've tried everybody else.
Right. I can
understand. You have some cake on you, too, yes.
Yes, do I?
Yes, it's
okay.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Yes, good.
What, but you realize I'm 50. How old are you now?
50? I've been 50 twice. don't worry about old age.
No revealing. You're not going to have anything fixed anymore now, are
you?
Oh,
yes. Can't wait.
Oh,
it's falling, too. Part of my face is on my chest right this minute. Of course, I could always use it there.
You're going to go under the knife again?
Why not?
Yes?
Yeah, well, the doctor's got a boat payment due. What can I? I want to help.
How many times is this now?
Well, I've had two lifts, you know. If I get another one, it'll be cesarean.
Understand. What's the most difficult portion to have fixed?
The most difficult portion? I would say the nose.
Yeah?
Oh, my God. Well, they bandage your whole head up, and you have nothing out but your mouth, and you think you're going to suffocate.
Right.
They assure you you aren't, and you don't. Of course, I guess a butt job would be hard.
But they the old bun,
they do buns. Okay. The bun lift.
Yeah. Have you had some people say that they grab it from the bottom and sort of pull it all the way up.
That's the way they do everything. They grab it from the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
You've done a little of that.
Yes, once in a while, yes. I haven't had anything lifted yet. I'm going to think about it in a while. You know?
Well,
what was the first time you had something done?
Oh, that was the complete facelift and the nose job and the boob.
You had your boobs done?
Oh, I have everything done.
I'm just surprised.
The only thing left of my original body are my elbows.
What are you going to do
with
them?
They're not good. They're not good. Really.
By the way, but we never got the chance either to thank you, too, for when we had that satellite with Bob Hope was here. He was absolutely thrilled that you showed
fun.
Up on the other end. Yeah, really good.
Oh, yes. I'm just into surprises now.
Mm.
Nothing regular, just the surprise. Right.
And you're going to take care of yourself now, because the last time, I remember, what was it, 3 times ago or something, you fell out of bed and broke your arm.
Oh, well, who could break their arm in bed but me?
Yeah. Mm.
Really. Mm. But I'm so happy that I was invited to get out of the cake, because sometimes the jobs are not what I really want. Next month, I'm booked for a luau. I'm coming out of a pig. This I prefer.
Yes, I think it's much better.
I like it.
You're going to hang around for a while?
Oh, yes, I'm coming to the party.
Okay, do we take a commercial break? Is that what we do? Okay, we're going to take a commercial break. Phyllis is going to hang around, and I don't know what else is happening. But hang in there. We're going to have a good time.
Thank heaven for rosy girls, for rosy girls get better every day. Thank heaven for rosy girls, they grow up in the most delightful way. With compliments the gentlemen of Paris present to them a fragrance called Australis. Thank heaven for rosy girls, a fragrance for them all, no matter where, no matter who. Australis, from Paris to you. From Paris, from Paris, Australis for rosy girls.
I can tell from her voice she's happy. Most of the time we talk about the family, the brothers and sisters and what they do. There's a few jokes that my son likes to talk to my mother about.